for one fall. Introducing first from Boca Raton, Florida, Ethan Carter the Third, EC3.
And here he comes. How about that? The nephew of TNA president Dixie Carter on Xplosion.
You know, JB, a lot of people feel that Ethan Carter the Third is entitled. You talked about the relation with Dixie Carter, Aunt D, as he always refers to her. I'll say one thing, it's opened a lot of doors for EC3 and TNA and Impact Wrestling. But you have to look at that one loss record at the end of the day. And even with a lot of help from his friends, it's still damn impressive.
Well, it's impressive. It's also impressive the way he blasts it out on Twitter every 5 seconds. Yeah, I beat Sting. I beat Kurt Angle. You listen to the guy, you follow him on Twitter, you think he's the greatest wrestler of all time.
Yeah, never referring to the fact that he did have help from some of his associates, friends of EC3, associates of EC3. And, of course, pressured to do so by our TNA president.
And his opponent from Nashville, Tennessee, accompanied by ODB, Eric Young.
Now, here's a slice of Americana, huh? You got these two coming out, ODB and Showtime Eric Young, stepping in to the ring with EC3 on Xplosion.
Yeah, you think of husband and wife. You think of the poster children, would that be right?
Poster children for something, yes.
And you immediately think of ODB and EY.
You also think of Off the Hook, Extreme Catches, his hawk show, his fishing show. He goes out and does all kinds of crazy things.
Big Animal Planet guy, right?
Well, not only that, now it's available in the United Kingdom. He's doing great. Fans behind him, Eric Young, especially with an opponent like that. EC3 solidly has the backing of this United Kingdom crowd, Eric Young, a perennial favorite.
Yeah, and then you have ODB at ringside. You know that she's going to be keeping an eye out for her husband. And you know ODB as well, not afraid to get physically involved. Awful lot of initials here. You've got EC3, EY, and ODB, JB.
Not to mention the fact you've got Steve Linsky, old SL in the ring, the referee.
Good old Steve Linsky.
Eric Young quickly chases EC3 out of the ring, and look at that, claims victory already. This guy is on a different planet when it comes to arrogance, confidence.
Steve Linsky?
No, EC3, it's over the top with this guy. Boca Raton, Florida, the nephew of Dixie Carter III, stepping into the ring here against Eric Young, a huge fan favorite here in the United Kingdom.
The unpredictability of Eric Young would, to me, be the story of this matchup and how EC3 is going to be able to deal with that.
On a very short time, we've seen some lopsided matches, I think, for the first several months of EC3's arrival. But since then, it's shown a new viciousness, especially with the Olympic gold medalist Kurt Angle.
Yeah, you think back to the first matches of EC3 on Impact Wrestling, back in the Norv Furnham and Dewey Barnes era of his career.
I'm sure that's what many will refer to it. And look at that. Handstand right in the ringside area. We're gonna see how this goes for Eric Young.
We're gonna see how it goes for EC3.
And he connects. Look at this. Eric Young now positioning himself in the middle of the ring. Here he comes. Over the top rope to the floor. Takes down EC3.
Hit it nicely. Cross body block out to the arena floor, as you mentioned. And Eric Young has taken control here early on.
Back into the ring now. Eric Young goes to the cover. One. EC3 in a very short time certainly has elevated himself in the ring, taking out the lights of Kurt Angle. We saw what happened with Sting, and tonight he's going to try it with Eric Young. And over the top rope goes Eric Young to the floor. Tough landing as ODB quickly rushes to his aid. And ladies and gentlemen, this matchup will continue when we return. It's EC3 versus Eric Young here on Xplosion. We are back. It's Xplosion exclusive action. EC3 going to work on EY. Eric Young and Mike Tenay. It was all EC3 during the break.
Yeah, more of the same. As we went to the commercial break, we saw Eric Young with a bad landing outside. EC3 attempting now to capitalize on that. It's been a full court press. And he realizes that he has Eric Young right now weakened to the point where potentially he could hit him with that 1%er and put him away.
Well, he has done that to many victims along the way, along his path. And interesting to note, though, now since we're in the United Kingdom, this TNA in the UK, interesting to see the dynamics unfold before our very own eyes with the World Heavyweight Champion Magnus, fellow Dixieland family member.
Yeah, it's a unique relationship, isn't it? Is EC3 going to try and lock on his attempt at a sleeper hold? Don't think he really has it cinched in too well. The series of elbows to the midsection by EY going to create some separation before Carter goes back to that sleeper hold again. Yeah, you talked about the relationship that EC3 has had with the World Heavyweight Champion Magnus. And again, it's almost a part of that whole entitlement story where our TNA president, Dixie Carter, has aligned EC3, her nephew, with the best.
And don't even get us started on Rockstar Spud.
It's a chief of staff, you know.
No question about it here. It's two now for Eric Young. Does he have enough? Has he been taken out by EC3? And just in the nick of time comes two. And needs to fight out of this. Does so with a left elbow to the midsection. Into the ropes now goes Eric Young. Ducks the clothesline. And once again, EC3 goes for it. Connects and no. Belly to back suplex.
Yeah, every attempt that we've seen from Eric Young to gain some momentum has been cut off by EC3, who has repeatedly gone back to the sleeper. And now Eric Young going to try and get some offense rolling here at the expense of Ethan Carter III.
EY Eric Young now into the ropes, reverses by EC3, up and over the top rope. And look at this, a little strutting into the midsection goes Eric Young, and
whoa,
through the legs. Ducks down, Eric Young connects.
It's one of those things, JB. You always talk about how unpredictable Eric Young is, how out of control as he hits the belly-to-belly and follows up with a two count. Do not dismiss his ability inside the squared circle. Eric Young has proven time after time through the years to be a terrific competitor. Sometimes he just loses that focus. Looks like he's got that concentration level high here. Wait a minute, what happened? Steve Linsky shoved off into the ropes by EC3, and EY crashes down to the canvas. There's the one percenter.
Right on top of the head. Two and three. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, EC3, Ethan Carter III.
That's the one percenter. Gains yet another victory for EC3. Yes, the nephew of our TNA president, Dixie Carter, victorious.